Hey everyone, this is the Fusion Presents Music City Surrey Showcase, funded by the City of Surrey, and we are back to show even more incredible Surrey talent. My name is Keely Ramage-Scott, and today I am joined with a familiar face. It's Miss WILONA. WILONA, how are you today?
I'm doing good.
It's been a while since we've seen you, and I know last time we had a lot of conversations about influence, and I also now know that you're working on new music, so I can't wait to hear like how your influences and the music that you've been listening to over the last year have kind of helped you kick off the writing process for this new song. So maybe just tell me a bit about it and about how it got started.
Okay, so the writing process for this song was it's actually about something that happened in my life, and just basically, it's called Safety Net, and it's like, you know, when you're in a new relationship and, you know, you feel like you're starting to fall, but then you've been through the whole heartbreak before, and like, you're trying to avoid that. So it's like, I'm scared if I let go of the safety net, you take me high just to bring me down. That's kind of like the hook of it. In terms of like my writing inspirations, I would say Tate McRae. I really admire Taylor Swift's songwriting. I hope one day to be as amazing as she is in songwriting.
Yeah, Taylor Swift has a way with words. I'm personally like such a huge fan of the Red album, and I think Red itself and then Treacherous are two tracks that like the lyricism and the poetry of her writing just draws me towards stuff like that. Do you have any like specific songs in your life that you've listened to and really drawn that kind of writing influence from? Like what makes you think of those kinds of emotions and feelings? Like what helps you to get into that sort of headspace yourself?
Songwriting for me is a bit weird because I don't really have an instrument that I'm good at. So I know most people, like, they get on the piano or guitar and then they write a song, but I just write a song. Maybe I have a tune in my head and then I just sing it out, and then I get the producer to make the beat, like, custom to that song. So, yeah, that's kind of, like, how it goes for me. Just kind of, like, what I'm feeling. Literally my life story, basically. But then I just try to, like, make it more Taylor Swift. That's the best way to explain it. Because she has this really amazing way to, like, tell a story that is so unique. Instead of, like, just... Because sometimes I feel like some of my lyrics is, like... I don't know, a child doing poetry. I'm like, it could be way better. So yeah, that's basically it.
Yeah, I find it, songwriting itself can be a struggle to bridge sort of the creative mind of the poetry. And then also you got to think of the simplicity so that people can understand it. That can be such a fine line.
Exactly. And I try not to like copy and paste. Like I had, and it's so hard like to draw inspiration without like, literally copying and pasting. So I ended up doing something entirely different, even though I was inspired by a said person. But I'm just trying to like study her songwriting technique and like artists who like their songwriting is really amazing, and see how I can implement that into my own songwriting without sounding exactly like the person.
Yeah, you have to have that individuality.
Yeah.
Tell me, what's the process been like working with your producer on this new track? Kind of where are you at right now? Where are you hoping to take it? What kind of work have you guys put in so far?
The song should be finished. It's at a stage where it's already mixed and mastered, but then I just didn't like how I sounded. Yeah. And I just hated everything. It was done, I think, last month, but I took a break from it because I kept listening to it over and over again. But then 2 weeks ago, I listened to it again. I was like, okay, it's actually really good. I just want to like fix some things and just embrace my voice, because I've been very insecure about my voice. And when I listen to myself sing or speak, I feel like I sound like a teddy bear or like a soft child. Like, and then when I hear myself sing, it's like this soft, childish, I don't know, childlike voice. And I've been trying to run away from that, but instead of doing that, I just want to like embrace the voice and re-record the song again with me embracing it. So that's what happened.
That's so important. Like, I feel like so many people have that experience too, and they don't know how to embrace it. So it's so powerful that you're able to kind of take that feeling and run with it too. Yeah, like so many artists I know also are just like, oh, I love to sing, but I hate listening back to the sound of my own voice. So many artists as me, I'm also that person. I hate the sound of my own voice on recordings, but being able to embrace that is, yeah, I think that everything comes out so much better when you have that confidence. You think it's going to feel better.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's like a weight lifted off my shoulders.
Yeah.
And funny thing, I think listening, when it comes to listening taste, people have what they like to listen to. And I've had a couple people saying, oh, they like my voice. But then I've had a couple people saying that I don't sound emotional enough. Like sometimes when I'm singing, I look like the emotion I'm singing, but then it doesn't translate to my actual voice. And I'm just like, maybe I'm this big empty hole, which is ironic because I'm very emotional. I'm a Cancer and I have all these emotions and I'm a crier. So it's weird that I can't actually translate that to my voice. Maybe it will come in time, but I'm no longer like putting so much pressure on myself. I'm just going to keep doing it until,
yeah,
you know, with practice, and it's going to come on, I think.
Weird thing to say to someone too is to ask them to express vulnerability more to a huge audience, because we're trained to think that vulnerability and emotionalness is a bad thing in professional circumstances. But being an artist is the only place where people want to see you bare your soul to the world like that.
Right, exactly. Yeah. I think my problem is just like, because it's very, very raw when I'm writing by myself. Mm-hmm. But I think in terms of singing it, just being aware that, oh, there are people listening or people are going to listen to this is just like, I don't know, maybe that's where the problem is. I'm still figuring it out.
Yeah. I think it's awesome to recognize that so many people feel the same way too, because you've got a mutual support system of so many artists out there with the same struggles. And I just love the community that we've built, not just in Surrey but in the Lower Mainland as well. Like having the live show that we did last year with Music City Surrey, I know that you weren't able to make it for health reasons, but even not outside of that show, I saw people connecting. Like I know you've connected with a couple of the other artists that we worked with last year. Yeah. So having those mutual struggles and having people you can lean on is so important. And I love the aspect of community building. Can you share more about like how being a part of the community has felt for you?
It's been really eye-opening because I've been here for like a long time, and it's just like surreal how like, I mean, it looks like a mystery, like the music scene in Vancouver, but when you actually start to like immerse yourself in it, it's so huge, but it's like so small, like this close knit of people, and it's really amazing. And one of the people that I really connect with a lot is Argel. Maybe it's because he migrated here as well, because when I think about like all the musicians I've met so far, truly amazing by the way, but then I think about their journey and I'm like, oh my God, I'm literally just starting out. Like, but then I think, okay, for the last few years, I've been schooling and working and trying to pay my tuition fee, international fees, which is really high. So I shouldn't be hard on myself. And when I heard Argel talk about like his story, and I was just like, wow, it feels so good to like know there's someone in the industry with a similar background as mine. And he's doing really amazing.
Yeah. Yeah. Gratifying. It's cool to see that also development isn't linear, I'm sure. And a mystery is such an interesting way to put the scene, because yeah, once you break into those like subgroups, I think it's such a nice community that you can find.
Yeah, it is.
Sorry, go ahead.
Well, I was just gonna say, like, it's really amazing. Like, honestly, I do wish I can go for like more shows and more things. Like, I have so many things saved on my Instagram that, oh, I'm gonna go for, but then it's so hard balancing that with like work. And because music itself doesn't really pay the bills, I'm like, you know, I have to do my 9-to-5 job, and I'm trying to like grow my YouTube channel to a place where it can start paying something so I can invest it back into the music. But I'm just like, sometimes I'm just like, I don't know how to balance all these things, like going out to shows and because I really want to experience it. Because to me, it's just like, I'm like a child. Like the first time, I think the first show I went to was Tess Anderson. She was Maddie King. Oh, I saw you there.
Yeah,
actually.
I was there.
Yes. And in my head, maybe my body language didn't seem like it because I'm very shy. But in my head, it was just like, I was like, wow. Like it was explosions in my mind because I'm like, why did it take me so long? Like, it's really amazing. I would love to do that more.
And reminder, music isn't paying the bills yet. We'll find a way to get there.
I hope so.
I know I asked you last year about some advice that you had for other people who are just starting out. Do you have anything new to share in the year since you were here last?
Let's see. I would say it's a journey for sure. And just to be very patient and keep working on yourself. And if there's anyone in my shoes that has a day job and trying to pursue this thing, I would say do not give up. Like if you really want it, it'd be harder, but be patient and try as much as possible to find that balance between your day job and your regular job. Because life can happen and you might be thinking, you know, maybe I should give up this. Maybe I'm too old. I had someone on my YouTube channel question like, oh, I think they're 20 something or 25, 26. And they're like, oh, is it too late to start? I'm like, no, it's not too late. We're in a day and age right now with social media that you can be 26 and still start. And if you're patient and you're on your grind, you definitely get somewhere. And I think those rap girlies, I don't know if you know them, Flyana Boss on TikTok.
No, I don't think so.
They had a song like Hello Christ that went viral on TikTok. Mm-hmm. It's a rap song. You never heard it?
No.
Really? Oh my God. Sorry. Well, they're in their 30s and they've been making music for a while, but it just happened for them. So my advice to anyone will be to just keep grinding and you get there as long as you don't give up.
Yeah. That's awesome advice. Thank you. And remind us, where can we find you online again?
On Instagram and TikTok. I'm very active on there and YouTube as well, at Wilona Joy.
Perfect. All right. Well, thanks for joining us again. We can't wait to have you sing again for this series. And thanks everyone at home for tuning in to another episode of the Music City Surrey Showcase. We'll see you in the next video.
Maybe you don't like talking too much about yourself, but you should have told me that you were thinking about someone else. You're drinking at a party, or maybe it's just that your car broke down. Your phone's been off for a couple months, so you're calling me now. I know you like this. When shit don't go your way, you needed me to fix it, like me, I did. But I ran out of every reason. Now suddenly you're asking for it back. Could you tell me where'd you get the nerve? Yeah, you can say you miss all that we had, but I don't really care how bad it hurts. When you broke me first, you broke me first. Took a while, was in denial when I first heard that you moved on quicker than I could have ever, you know that hurt. Swear for a while I was staring at my phone just to see your name, but now that it's there I don't even know what to say. I know you like this. When shit don't go your way, you needed me to fix it, and like me I did. But I ran out of every reason. Now suddenly you're asking for it back. Could you tell me where'd you get the nerve? Yeah, you can say you miss all that we had, but I don't really care how bad it hurts. When you broke me first, you broke me first. What did you think will happen? What did you think will happen? I'll never let you have it. What did you think will happen? Now suddenly you're asking for it back.
Could you tell me where'd you get the nerve? Yeah, you can say you miss all that we had, but I don't really care how bad it hurts when you broke me first.